Okay, Bay State running here with Mike Miller of Weymouth, whose team just captured the Division 1A state meet here today. Mike, you got to be happy. This is a team that's been running well all season long, and now to do what they did today, it's a great effort.
Yeah, no question. I was really proud of the girls. We had a little bit of a setback 2 weeks ago at the conference meet. Brookline, who's an outstanding team, they're probably second today. They gave it to us, and we needed to work really hard the last 2 weeks, and we kind of refocus our energy and attention. And these guys did it, and I couldn't be more proud of them.
Now, Mike, I know you're an energetic type person, and you're all over the place during meets like this. How was your nerves throughout this meet, being this close and with Brookline and everybody else?
I was nervous to a point, but the way the girls were approaching it, the way the girls went out, their first 1,000 was perfect. It was everything we asked them to do. That calms your nerves a lot as a coach. Ultimately, this isn't about me. It's the seven of them. It's the 32 of us in the program that do this. You don't need to get nervous when your kids do the right thing every day and care about each other, and that's all this is about.
So how did you prepare him this week for this meet, knowing it was going to be close and knowing how well your girls have been doing this year?
Yeah, to be honest, we tried not to talk a lot about anybody else, just take care of what we needed to do. We talked about six in the top 25, and I think we did that, or we were really close if we didn't. We thought that would be enough to get it done and just do our thing. I think Ella Bates and Allison Glavin finished, 11, 12, something like that. And then we rolled in. Gracie Richard had a great race. Emma Dorn had the best race of her life. Emma Daly, Shea Roach, they were right there in top 25. And Mariana Collins from 7 for us, she took care of business and did what we asked her to do as well. So I'm really proud to see these guys all come out and race tough and race the way that they did.
Now, Mike, I know right at the beginning of the season you knew this team was a team capable of doing what they did. When was the turning point? When did you feel that this team was capable of doing what they did this year?
Ironically, it was probably at the Twilight meet, because we went in and blew up our whole race plan. I mean, we've been running packs all season. At Twilight, I don't think any of them knew where each other were. And then we ended up winning. I think, when things go awry and you can still get it done, that's a big lesson for the kids, that if it doesn't have to be perfect, it just has to be good enough. And today, we weren't perfect. We were pretty close, but we were definitely good enough. And I'm just, really, really proud of them. And they just believed in each other all season long.
So, Mike, the All-State meet next week, this maybe puts a little pressure on your girls this week?
I don't think so. I think, we sort of circled our calendar here and said what happens next week happens next week. We felt pretty confident we were going to make it. And now, we get to enjoy this. We're going to spend a couple of days enjoying this. I know it's been 10 years for our program, and you don't get it. It doesn't come down every day, and I'm just really proud of them. I'm really happy that we get to, enjoy this. And we won't rest on our laurels. We'll give it our best shot next week, but today's about today.
Well, Mike, congratulations on a great team effort, and good luck next week.
Thanks
a great job.
Appreciate it. Thanks.